Hello, it's Carly McAvoy. Today I'm talking about rational functions. One of the things that they're going to ask you to do when you're dealing with rational functions is to find the indicated value. When they say find the indicated function values, that just means substitute and simplify. So here's your function f of x, and this is the definition of your function, and they're saying find f of 2. So to find f of 2, you're going to take that function and you're going to replace you're going to replace the x with 2 everywhere you see an x. So they're saying instead of x, put a 2 in for x and then simplify. That's all they're asking you to do. I want to show you this one where they have a 4. If they asked you to find f of 4, you're replacing the x with 4. We have 4 squared and 3 times 4 plus 2, and then we have on the bottom 4 minus 4, and that's a problem because no matter what you get on the top there, you're going to get 0 in the denominator, and so this one is undefined. The first one has an answer. I didn't work it out. The last one I will work out for you. F of negative 1 is going to be negative 1 to the second power minus 3 times negative 1 plus 2 all over negative 1 minus 4. Notice I put parentheses around there because I want to make sure I get my sign correct. Negative 1 times negative 1 is 1. Negative 3 times negative 1 is positive 3. And then in the denominator I have negative 5. So in the numerator I have 1 plus 3 is 4, 5, 6, and I have negative 6/5 for that one. Okay, if they ask you for the domain of a function, it's all the possible values of x. So if you look at this first one, they're saying, what is the domain of this function? Well, they ask you to state it in set builder notation, which is the set of all x such that x does not equal. What we're interested in is what can the x's not be here? It could be every x except what? And to figure that out, we're going to set our denominator equal to 0 and solve. Now, this is a difference of squares, so we're going to set that difference of squares, each part equal to 0. And that gives me x is 3 or x is negative 3. X cannot be 3 or negative 3. That's the domain is every x in the universe except those two numbers. Because 3 squared is 9, minus 9 would be 0, and negative 3 squared is negative 3 times negative 3, also 9, and that would also give us 0. So what about this one? We have 15x squared plus 22x minus 9 equals 0. You can spend some time factoring. I'm not teaching factoring on this one. I bet it's 3 and 5... 9 and 1, 27 minus. Okay, so that would be 15x squared, and 27 minus 5 is 22, and 1 times 9 is 9, and my signs look good. So then I would just set each of those equal to 0, and I'm going to move the 1 to the other side and divide by 3 to get x is 1/3. For the other one, I'm going to move the 9 to the other side and divide by 5 to get negative 9 over 5. Now, solving those basic equations should be something that you have confidence in at this level of the game. But you can take a little more time and solve them out if you'd like. If you're asked to simplify a rational expression, we're saying factor and cancel out like terms. When you factor the top here, all you can really do is take out a common term of 5. That would leave x minus 7. In the denominator, again, we can take out a common factor of y, which is leaving y minus 7. And then I have y minus 7 in common, so my simplified form of that would be 5 over y. Remember, when you cancel opposites, you get negative 1. Showed you an example for part A that's very simple, 5 over negative 5, sorry about that. 5 over negative 5 is negative 1. What about x minus 2 over 2 minus x? Well, those are opposites because this is positive and that's negative. These are opposites as well, negative 2 and positive 2. So when you have a binomial that's an opposite, then that cancels out to be negative 1. So that's going to be negative 1. How we could see it another way is factor the negative 1 out of the bottom. That negative negative makes that a positive x. And positive, we factor out the negative, we get a negative 2. And then you can see that those two binomials are the same, but this negative comes about in the process of doing that. Over here, once I see that I have x minus 4 and 4 minus x, which are opposites, I know they cancel, and that gives me a negative. So that whole thing is equal to negative, and then I have negative x plus 5, or another way to say that would be negative x minus 5. The negative came from canceling those opposites. What about something like this? If I factor the denominator, again, that's a difference of squares. Difference of squares, we say, what's the square root of this? The positive square root is 2. And the square root of this is 3x. So I have plus 3x and minus 3x. And what we want to recognize here is that 3x minus 2 and 2 minus 3x are opposites, because the negative 2, positive 2, positive 3x, negative 3x. So when they cancel, we get negative 1. And that means that the simplified version of this is negative 1 over 2 plus 3x. Notice, because the x term was in the second spot, it's in the second spot when we factor it. We can't just move those unless we want to put a negative in there. Okay, two more problems on this one. What if you were asked to simplify an expression like this? We would simplify by factoring the top. That's a difference of squares. That's going to be p plus 6 and p minus 6. And then the denominator, that's going to be 2p and p, 1, and they're both negative. That would give me 2p squared minus 6 and minus 1, minus 12, excuse me, a negative 1, and then two negatives make a positive. P minus 6 are not opposites, they're just the same term, so they would cancel, and I would be left with P plus 6 and 2P minus 1. Notice I can't cancel those P's out. That P and this P, both part of a binomial. I can't take part of a binomial. And the last one is a factor by grouping problem. Remember, we can factor by grouping. We just group the first two terms, or sometimes we have to rearrange them, but this one looks like it's going to work nicely without that, and the second two terms. Now, the common mistake is for people to cancel before they should. So be careful. You can't cancel until you're completely factored. On the top, we can take out b squared. That would leave b minus 5. And we can take out, whoops, I think that might have copied that down wrong, because it doesn't make any sense unless that's a plus. Sorry. And that could give us b plus 5. And up here, I'm going to take out the negative 7, which is going to give us b plus 5, right? Dividing by negative 7 gives us a plus 5. And then I have the b plus 5 down below. I'm not finished factoring on the top. On the top, I take out the common factor of b plus 5, which leaves b squared minus 7. And I have the b plus 5 down below. So I did have this as a minus. Remember, I had to change it to a plus for this to work out. But now that I'm completely factored, now I can cancel those, and my final answer is just b squared minus 7. Notice that I need to make sure I leave the answer where it is. In other words, the leftover was in the numerator here. But in this problem, the leftover was in the denominator, and that's where it is when I state the answer. So be careful that you're leaving the leftover term in its correct spot. Have a fantastic day. I'll see you next time.